Hello, this is Rupinder Syal and welcome to Spartan Tutorials. Around 4th century BCE, ancient Greece, people who suffered from various debilitating diseases went to healing temples or Asclepions. These were temples dedicated to the Greek god Asclepius. And here they underwent various rituals like catharsis, which involved various types of fasting, as well as a peculiar procedure called encoimesis, or incubation, where they went through a dreamlike state, probably induced by hallucinogens, and where they were instructed that a cure for their disease would be revealed by Asclepius or one of his daughters in their dreamlike state. Now cut back to almost 2500 years later, and now neuroscientists as well as scientists working with sleep and dreams have developed technologies that promise to revolutionize our understanding of sleep, as well as influencing our behavior by intercepting and interjecting into our sleep. This technology is called targeted dream incubation. Now, what is this technology and how much of it is hype and how much of it is reality? Let's talk about it in this video. Now, sleep and the process of dreaming have been a subject of intense research as well as intrigue over the past several centuries. Modern research has revealed the various patterns of brain activity during sleep as well as dreams. But still, we are just scratching at the surface of what goes on when people dream. And we are not even sure why do we sleep. Although there are some hints that maybe we do it to process and prune our memories, but still, we really lack a molecular mechanism of how sleep functions, how dreams function. And there have been many historical figures who have revealed that they got the solution to their problems, whether it was Auguste Kekule working on the structure of benzene, or Mendeleev working on the periodic table, or Elias Howe, who discovered the structure of putting the hole in the sewing needle. They said that they were all revealed to them in a kind of a vision in their dreams. So although there is no woo-woo stuff here that I would like to say, but it really indicates that there is an altered state of consciousness that we enter between that sleep and dreamlike state that we can exploit to solve our problems and get guidance from our own mind. This is tapping into our own unconscious. Now, classically, scientists have realized that there are four different levels of sleep as well as a heightened activity which is called REM sleep. So these four stages, they are called the non-REM sleep or non-rapid eye movement sleep, and these represent various degrees of lowered states of consciousness. So we are going to deep and deep sleep as we go from stage 1 to stage 4. And every 1.5 hour or so, we experience a small state of rapid eye movement as well as body paralysis, which is indicated by this phase called REM sleep or rapid eye movement sleep. And this is the phase where dreams happen. A typical person experiences 4 cycles of REM sleep during their average 7 to 8 hours of sleep every night. And disturbances in REM sleep as well as other stages of non-REM sleep have been associated with various disorders and have been associated with mood disorders as well as depression. So it is really important that we understand what is going on in our sleep. And scientists have tried to pry apart what is going on in the mind of people who dream and what is the stuff the dreams are made of, so to say. So in a study published in the year 2000 in the journal Science showed that people who played the computer game Tetris, they often dreamed of that game. And this was shown that amnesics who had loss of majority of the functions of the medial temporal lobe, they also had these experiences. And recently, just last year, we had a remarkable breakthrough where real-time dialogue happened between experimenters and people who were dreaming during the REM sleep. So in this study, researchers placed these probes on the face as well as the head of the subjects, and they were chosen for 3 different stimuli, either spoken words or flashing lights, which flashed in Morse code, which was already known to the subjects, and tactile stimuli like touch. And they were asked different questions. For example, what is 8 minus 6? Or do you speak Spanish? Or in the Morse code, 4 minus 0 is what? To the surprise of the experimenters, the subjects were able to respond. And they respond in a very correct fashion. For example, a non-Spanish speaking person was asked, do you speak Spanish? And he replied, no. And they were woken up just after their REM sleep was monitored, because based on the brain waves, the scientists can predict when they are undergoing REM sleep. So just after the REM sleep and the asking of the question, they were immediately woken up for a small amount of time and they were asked, okay, what were you dreaming and what did you see? They're saying, so in one case, he said, I was at a party with my friends and a voice was coming from the outside. Okay, do you speak Spanish? Do you speak Spanish? So something was interjecting into the dream. So this is proper dream manipulation. It looks like sci-fi and science fiction, but it is real. So this is getting really, really creepy. And now we have an app or a system called Dormio. In Dormio, a similar concept is applied, but in a very short time frame. So the subject here wears eye mask to make sure that they are sleeping, and they wear sensors as well as there is an app which monitors their heart rate as well as different body movements to detect when they are undergoing into the hypnagogia state or hypnagogic state. This is a state between sleep and awake. So you may have realized, like, when you are trying to sleep and you are just going into the sleep, that continuum of time when you are neither sleep nor awake, that is called hypnagogia. So Dormio system, which is a new software as well as an app, it is open source and it is being used by researchers. It is a new system where they probe people who are going through this first level of non-REM sleep, which is the hypnagogic state. And before the start of the experiment, they ask them to define a problem. For example, they say to themselves, remember to think of a tree. So when they reach that state, they are probed and they are asked, okay, what? Tell me, what was going through your mind? And it is recorded. It is all done automatically, so there is no human intervention here, but the person records. So the person records, okay, this was what was going through my mind. And this is done 2 to 3 times. Although this experiment takes half an hour to 45 minutes, but it is still very revealing that some people do think of whatever they were thinking about and whatever they were saying, that I will think about this. So what is the controversy now? Actually, in February 2021, Coors, which is a beer brand, it could not place its ads in the Super Bowl, which happened on 8th of February. Because of an exclusive contract, they were barred from advertising during Super Bowl. Instead, they tried to have a new experiment. What they did was, they paired up with Dr. Deirdre Barrett, who is a professor at Harvard Medical School, specializing in sleep and dreams, and they made this hallucinogenic, very chill kind of positive vibes mountain waterfall filled commercial of Coors Light, their beer. So this is the commercial. I hope I don't get a copyright strike from YouTube on that. So if you get a cut from this video, you can follow this link right here. But let me play a small part of this. So as you can see, that this is pretty vivid imagery, and this was a dream sequence that the subjects were allowed to watch, and then they were told that, okay, you tell yourself that you want to think about this during your sleep. So there was an intention involved, and to their surprise, many subjects actually saw those things in their dreams. They saw the waterfalls, they saw the cool lake, they saw Coors Light in their dreams. Pretty powerful stuff. and it is very creepy again. And now the other companies are also jumping in on the bandwagon and they are aggressively moving in on this phenomenon. Burger King in 2018, so that's about 3 years ago, launched a new burger which was called their Nightmare King. And they said that this is clinically proven to induce nightmares. Almost twice the number than the usual average of people who experience nightmares was seen when people consumed this nightmare of a burger. It was linked to the enormous amount of fat and protein present in this burger, which probably interfered with the REM sleep. And Xbox also is looking into this. They are looking into the lucid dreams. Lucid dreams and lucid dreamers refers to the fact that in lucid dreaming, the person is aware that he or she is dreaming. And Xbox is experimenting with a lot of stuff here, trying to basically visualize what the person's dream was like. Basically the same thing, they asked the person to wear a bunch of different devices, monitoring their sleep patterns and then asking, okay, what did you see in your dream? And then they collaborated with many different artists to recreate their dreams, which were purely hallucinogenic. And people were really freaked out by that. And now researchers from sleep psychology, as well as people who investigate dreams, they have issued a kind of an opinion article or an editorial kind of issuing a warning that this is a slippery slope. This should not continue. This is kind of going into uncharted territory. We are seeing the infiltration of smart speakers like Alexa and Siri and all these devices in our smart homes who can listen and can broadcast stuff. So if this technology is taken to its extreme, that's what the scientists think, this might lead to influences of their behavior or their purchasing preferences just based on manipulation of their dreams. So it is pretty creepy stuff, and that's why scientists are kind of on the ethical line here. They are drawing an ethical line here that this type of research should be curtailed and controlled. And the Science magazine recently wrote an article about it, Are Advertisers Coming for Your Dreams? And they cited some of the same studies that I have mentioned. And in response, Dr. Deirdre Barrett has pointed out a lot of limitations that this is not such a nightmarish scenario as it is being made out. So let me give you my verdict as well as what I gathered from my little survey of the literature. Is it reality or is it hype? Should we fear the inception-like scenario of science fiction where people can manipulate our dreams and unlock our passwords or secret details of our projects? It is unlikely to be. It is more hype at this moment than reality. And why? Because intention is first of all needed for any type of targeted dream incubation. You need to be intentional about it. You need to say to yourself, okay, I will think about this. Just like we saw in the other experiments, remember to think of the tree. And the people who were recruited for the Coors Light commercial experiment, they were also shown the Coors ad multiple times on their iPads just before going to sleep. And they told themselves that I will think about this while I sleep. So intention is definitely needed for incubation. Again, regulations are already in place in many different countries. Even FTC and many European countries already have regulations regarding sneaky and manipulative advertising. So I think, according to Dr. Barrett, as well as I also agree with her, that it is a little bit overhyped at this moment. It is not such a nightmarish scenario. And efficacy. Efficacy is a big point. This is a point that needs to be demonstrated, that whether it is efficient. Normal awake advertising works really, really well. And efficacy of this targeted dream incubation is still needs reproducibility, as well as it needs to be demonstrated that it is effective. In many of these studies, it was more like 20% or 30% of the respondents actually experienced these dreamlike states, as well as experienced the same objects in their dreams that they told themselves to. So it is not a foolproof phenomenon that, okay, you say that you will think about this and boom, voila, you will think about it and you will come up with the next periodic table or next big invention, or you will suddenly change your beer brand. So I think it is more hype at this point than reality. So we need to watch this space carefully, and I hope to keep you guys up with the latest developments in this field. Alright, that was my discussion of the new field of targeted dream incubation. If you like this video, please let me know. If you have any doubts, comments or questions, please let me know in the comment section below. Thank you for watching and I'll see you next time.